says that a complete metric space is of second category, that is non-meager in itself, right? And we proved that. And after that, we took an example, right, that the converse is not true. We have already stated that, right? And after that, we had defined point-wise bounded and uniformly bounded set, right? So set F was pointed bounded, point-wise bounded if for each x this set, the set of Tx, where T belongs to this family, is a bounded set, and it's uniformly bounded if it is bounded in the norm space, right? And bounded in the norm space means operator norm of T is less than equals to K for all T belongings to the family. Then next we saw that uniform boundedness implies pointed boundedness, and converse is not true. So to negate the converse, that the converse is not true, we took an example of a norm space X which was C00 with infinity norm, and the Banach space Y which is was equals to field K with their regular norm, right? And we showed that this operator Tn, which we defined as Tn of X is equals to n into zeta n, this was uniformly, this sequence Tn was point-wise bounded but not uniformly bounded, right? Now today what we are doing is uniform boundedness theorem. So for uniform boundedness theorem, what it says is, let Tn be a sequence of bounded linear operators, right? That means Tn is a sequence of bounded linear operators, and that means this each Tn is a bounded linear operator, right? And Tn are from X to Y, from a Banach space X to a norm space Y. So that means X is a Banach space and Y is just any norm space, right? And this sequence is such that this sequence of norms, norm of Tnx sequence, this is bounded for every X, right? So is sequence ke bounded hone ka matlab kya hai? That norm of Tnx is less than equals to Cx. And यहाँ पे cx लिखा होने का मतलब क्या है? That is this constant c is depending upon x, right? Where cx is a real number and ck subscript is x, that means c is depending upon x. For every x, this constant would be different. Next, we are saying that if this conditions hold, that means if Tn is a sequence of bounded linear operators, और जो each Tn है, that is an operator from Banach space to a norm space, such that the sequence of norms norm of Tnx is bounded, then we say that the sequence of norm Tn, norm of Tn, the sequence is bounded, right? That means agar har ek x ke liye point wise bounded ho raha hai and Tn jo hai Banach space se norm space ka sequence hai, then norm of Tn jo sequence aayega, that would also be bounded. That means norm of Tn would be less than equals to C for every C. This यहाँ पे जो c आएगा, that would be a constant number, not depending upon x or something, right? So if the statement is clear, right? So uniform boundedness क्या कहती है? अगर point wise boundedness हो रहा है, तो uniform boundedness हो जाएगा, given Tn जो है, वो Banach space से norm space के ऊपर operator है, and c bounded linear operator है, right? तो हर एक x के लिए अगर ये point wise boundedness हो रहा है, तो norm जो है, वो uniform bounded भी हो जाएगा. So to prove this, हम क्या कर रहे हैं? हर एक k belongings to n के लिए, for every k belongings to n, we can define an AK set. And AK set क्या है? All those x belongings to x, such that norm of Tnx is less than equals to k for every n, right? Now, ये जो AK set है, this is depending upon k, right? Because हम क्या लिख रहे हैं? Norm of Tnx is less than equals to k, right? तो ये जहाँ पे AK के A के सबस्क्रिप्ट में जो k है, वही k यहाँ पे आ रहा है, right? So therefore, AK is the set of all those x belongings to x such that this Tn of x is less than equals to k. Next, हम क्या शो कर रहे हैं कि AK जो है closed होगा. AK closed जो AK set है, this is a set contained in x because x में क्या थे? सारे के सारे boundary linear x जो है, x was a Banach space, right? जिसमें operators थे Tn x to y. Such that norm of Tnx is bounded for every x. That means सारे के सारे x belongings to x के लिए this condition was holding, right? So therefore this AK set would be contained in x. Next we prove that this AK set is closed. Closed दिखाने के लिए हम क्या लेंगे? That an element belongs to closure of the set, right? So we say that let x belongs to AK closure. And AK closure में belong करने का मतलब क्या है? That there would exist a sequence xn, right, which would be contained in A, and that sequence should converge to an element X, right? So x belongs to AK closure implies there would exist a sequence xn in AK such that xn converges to x. Now, for every fixed n, we are fixing n, right? For every fixed n, we would have then norm of tn of xj would be less than equals to k. Because sequence xn जो है AK में contain हो रही है, that means xn का sequence का हर एक element जो आएगा वो AK में belong करेगा, and AK में belong करेगा, that would imply tn of xn should be less than equals to k, for every n, right? हर एक n के लिए hold करेगा, so therefore the xj sequence के लिए भी hold करेगा, so therefore norm of tn of xj would be less than equals to k, since xn was belonging to AK. Next. Now, norm of tn of xk is less than equals to k. That would implies norm of tn of x would be less than equals to k. क्योंकि xj sequence जो थी, वो x को converge कर रही है, right? And norm continuous function है, तो इसमें convergence जो है, वो hold कर जाएगी. So, therefore, norm of tn of xj जो है, that would converge to norm of tn of x. And this should be less than equals to k, right? तो यहाँ से हमारे पास क्या आ गया कि norm of tnx, tn of x is less than equals to k. And that implies x belongs to AK because AK में वही elements हैं जिनका norm less than equals to k है, right? So therefore x belongs to AK. Then next, then we have that AK closure is contained in AK, right? So therefore AK is closed. ये clear है? Next, what we are doing is we are taking an element x belonging to X, right? If element x is belonging to X, then implies x जो है एक AK में belong कर जाएगा for sum k, because norm of tnx जो है bounded है for हर x के लिए, right? हमें hypothesis में क्या given है that norm of tnx is bounded for every x, right? Such that norm of tnx is bounded for every x belongings to x. That means x का हर एक element जो है that is such that उसका operator के ऊपर this norm of tnx is less than equals to cx, right? So अगर x का हम कोई भी element लेंगे that implies x जो है किस for sum के AK में belong करेगा, right? Therefore x can be written as union of AK, k is equals to 1 to infinity. This is clear? Now x जो है एक हम already hypothesis में लिख चुके हैं कि x is a Banach space, right? That means complete space. And complete space को अगर हम union countable union of some sets लिख रहे हैं, then that means एक at least set जो है Bayes category theorem कल की थी. That would imply that this at least one AK जो है वो rare नहीं होगा, and rare नहीं होने का मतलब क्या है, उसका interior जो है non-empty होगा, and that implies उसमें एक open bowl मिल जाएगी, right? That implies so some AK contains an open bowl, and we denote that open bowl by B naught, right? Let this ball be B naught. B naught ball कौन सी होगी? B ball centered at x naught with radius r, right? R radius की एक ball मिल जाएगी. Centered at x naught, right? And this ball would be contained in AK naught, because यहाँ पे अगर ball हमारे पास मिल रही है b of x naught, then that would implies tn of x naught would be less than equals to r, right? That means वो AK naught में contained हो जाएगा, right? So therefore b naught is contained in AK naught. Next we are taking an element x belongings to x which is non-zero, an arbitrary element, right? Now we substitute z is equals to x naught plus gamma x. यहाँ पे x naught भी x में है, x भी x में है, right? And gamma x scalar है, therefore and x एक Banach space है, that means vector space तो है ही. Therefore ये जो z element आएगा, that belongs to the space x, right? So z की ये definition जो है ये well defined है. And यहाँ पे हमने gamma को क्या define किया है? R upon 2 times norm of x. And R क्या था? This radius b naught ball का, right? So therefore, यहाँ से जब हम norm of z minus x naught निकालेंगे, norm of z minus x naught would be norm of gamma x, right? And that would be equals to modulus of gamma into norm of x, right? And modulus of gamma from here, जब हम substitute करेंगे, that would be equals to r by 2 norm x into norm x. Norm x and norm x cancel. This is equals to r by 2, and r by 2 is less than r. Therefore, what we have is that norm of z minus x naught is less than r, and that would imply ki z jo hai is ball mein belong kar jayega, the ball centered at x naught and with radius r, right? And ye ball kaun si thi? B naught ball thi, right? Kyunki ball mein agar kisi set mein element belong karna, that means agar ye do elements hai hamare paas z and x naught, ye z hai and x naught hai, x naught ke around humne ek ball banayi hai, theek hai, jiska radius r hai. If we are saying z और x naught का distance जो है, वो आर से छोटा है, दैट मीन्स ये जेड जो है ये इसी बॉल में बिलोंग करना चाहिए, राइट? सो देयरफॉर जेड बिलोंग्स टू बी नॉट, एंड जेड बिलोंग्स टू बी नॉट आई एम ऑलरेडी लिख चुके हैं दैट बी नॉट इज कंटेन्ड इन ए के नॉट, राइट? सो देयरफॉर जेड वुड बिलोंग्स टू ए के नॉट, एंड ए के नॉट में जेड बिलोंग करने का मतलब क्या होगा, दैट नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन जेड वुड बी लेस देन इक्वल्स टू के नॉट. इक्वेशन 3 इज क्लियर. From equation 3, next what we do is, now let again x naught jo element tha that was in b naught, right? And b naught mein tha, that definitely a k naught mein hoga, and a k naught mein hai, that would imply that norm of tn of x naught should also be less than equals to k naught. And ye k naught kyun likha hai? Because we are considering in a k naught. And jab a k set dekha tha, toh usme kya aaya tha? Norm of tn of x less than equals to k, right? Jab subscript a tha, ए का के था तो के के लेस देन था, एंड जब यहाँ पे के नॉट है देन दैट वुड बी लेस देन इक्वल्स टू के नॉट, राइट? सो देयरफॉर नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन ऑफ एक्स नॉट इज आल्सो लेस देन इक्वल्स टू के नॉट. नाउ एक्स नॉट का आ गया, जेड का आ गया, तो हम यहाँ से एक्स निकाल सकते हैं जेड की डेफिनेशन से, राइट? एंड देन एक्स वुड बी जेड माइनस एक्स नॉट अपॉन गामा. सो नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन ऑफ एक्स क्या होगा, एक्स की जगह सब्सिट्यूट करेंगे जेड माइनस एक्स नॉट अपॉन गामा, दिस वुड बी नॉर्म ऑफ दिस, राइट? गामा इज कॉन्स्टेंट, नॉर्म के बाहर आ जाएगा. That would be equals to norm of tn of z minus x naught. Now tn जो है एक bounded linear operator है, so linearity यहाँ पे hold कर रही है. So this can be written as tn of z minus tn of x naught. Next यहाँ पे हम क्या लगाएंगे, triangular inequality, right? So this can be written as this is less than equals to norm of tn z plus norm of tn of x naught. And norm of tn z we have already proved that this is less than equals to k naught by equation 3. We have already proved norm of tn of x naught is less than equals to k naught, right? So therefore, this is less than equals to k naught plus k naught, which is 2k naught by gamma. Then substituting the value of gamma, what we would have is that this norm of tn x is less than equals to 4k naught upon r into norm of x for every n. This holds for every n, right? So if we find the norm of the operator tn, norm of operator tn would be nothing but supremum of modulus of tnx upon norm of x for all x non equals to 0, right? Now modulus of tnx would be, यहाँ पे इसकी value डालेंगे, the supremum would be less than equals to 4 k naught upon norm of x, right? And norm x से norm x cancel बचेगा, हमारे पास क्या बचेगा, norm of tn is less than equals to 4 k naught by r. इसको अगर हम c value ले लेते हैं तो हमारे पास क्या आ जाएगा, norm of tn is less than equals to c for every n, right? That means TNC जो operator है वो bounded है for every n के लिए, and therefore this sequence of operators norm of TN is bounded. Clear है ये? इस theorem के proof में कहीं doubt हो तो पूछो. हमें प्रूव करना था कि नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन इज लेस देन इक्वल्स टू सी है फॉर एवरी एन, राइट? तो उसके लिए नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन को सबसे पहले हमें ये देखना है कि नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन निकालते कैसे हैं. तो नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन की डेफिनेशन होती है सुप्रीमम ऑफ एक्स बिलोंगिंग्स टू एक्स मॉड्यूलस ऑफ टी एन एक्स अपॉन नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स. तो दैट मीन्स हमें टी एन ऑफ एक्स चाहिएगा, राइट? सो टी एन ऑफ एक्स निकाला हमने पहले, सो टी एन ऑफ एक्स निकाला यहाँ, राइट? सो नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन एक्स निकाला, उसके लिए हमें क्या चाहिए था, x की वैल्यू, राइट? सो x हमें निकालना पड़ा, तो x को हमने सब्सिट्यूट किया था z इज इक्वल्स टू x नॉट प्लस दिस, नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन z निकाला, टी एन एक्स x नॉट निकाला, उससे नॉर्म ऑफ टी एन एक्स निकल गया, राइट? सो एनी डाउट इन दिस यू कैन आस्क. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट वी हैव अ नोट व्हिच सेज दैट the alternative statements for uniform boundedness theorem, right? So alternative statement क्या है इसकी? So for that let X be a Banach space. X हमने एक Banach space लिया था, and Y be a norm space, right? Over the field K. If a set F of bounded linear operators from X into Y is pointwise bounded, then it is uniformly bounded. यही sequence, यही theorem कह रही थी कि X अगर एक Banach space है and Y एक norm space है. And if a set of bounded linear operators, that means अगर Tn एक bounded linear operator है from x to y, right? From x to y, and pointwise bounded हो रहा है, that means modulus of Tnx is less than equals to c, then it is uniformly bounded. This was the sequence, this was the statement, right? So uniformly boundedness theorem, the alternative statement, this general statement. that point wise bounded implies uniformly bounded if X is a Banach space and the set is of bounded linear operators, right? So for this, now we have a question which says that let X be a Banach space and Y be a norm space, right? And Tn belongs to Bxy, that is a bounded linear operator from X to Y, such that the sequence Tnx is Cauchy in Y, right? Tnx would belongs to Y because Tn is an operator from X to Y, so Tnx jo hai wo Y mein belong karega, and we were given that the sequence of Tnx is this sequence is Cauchy in Y for every X, right? To show that this norm of sequences, that sequence norm of Tn is bounded, right? So इसमें हम यही वाली theorem apply करेंगे. Theorem apply करने से पहले हमें क्या चाहिए? Sequence of norm of Tnx हमें bounded दिखाना, right? So now, since Tnx sequence जो है हमें Cauchy sequence दी हुई है, that means this would be bounded in Y because Y जो है एक norm space था and Tn जो है एक bounded linear operator है, right? So Tnx जो sequence है, that would be bounded in Y, and that would imply norm of Tnx is less than equals to k for some k, right? कोई हमें बाउंडेड है Tnx, then that would imply कि हमें ऐसा k मिल जाएगा such that norm of Tnx is less than equals to k. Now, since Tn bounded linear operators है, x Banach space है, y norm space है, and this condition also that is point-wise bounded भी है, then by uniform boundedness theorem we would have a c belonging c constant such that norm of Tn would be less than equals to c, right? That means the sequence norm of Tn would be bounded. Any doubt in this? No doubt? So this is all for section 4.7. We have our next question. So if next question is, if Xn is in Banach space, right, that means sequence Xn is in a Banach space such that sequence f of Xn is bounded for every f belonging to X dash. That means bounded linear functional f, right? Now show that the sequence norm of Xn is also bounded, right? So ab humne operators ke upar theorem padhi thi. So we would have the term functionals also, which says that now. हमें गिवन क्या क्या है कि xn जो सीक्वेंस है वो बनाक स्पेस x में है सच दैट द सीक्वेंस f ऑफ xn बाउंडेड है, राइट? और f जो है वो क्या है, एक बाउंडेड लीनियर फंक्शनल है x के ऊपर. नाउ लेट अस डिफाइन अ फंक्शनल gn. gn हम फंक्शनल डिफाइन कर सकते हैं फ्रॉम x डैश टू k. x डैश टू k करने का मतलब gn जो है वो कहां पे बिलोंग करेगा, डबल डैश में, राइट? सो देयरफॉर gn बिलोंग्स टू x double dash. Now we have defined a functional gn from x dash to k such that gn of f. Now iski domain jo hai x dash hai and x dash mein elements kya hai, bounded linear functionals. So therefore gn of f humne define kiya hai that goes to f of xn, right? F of xn would be in field because f jo hai functional hai from x to k, right? So therefore f of xn would be in the field. So gn of f हमने define किया है by f of xn. We have already proved that this sequence, this gn f जो आएगा, this is bounded for every f, right? Because norm of gn of f निकालेंगे जब हम, that would be equals to norm of f of xn, and norm of f of xn जो है वो bounded है because f हमें दिया हुआ है is a bounded linear functional, right? So therefore this sequence gn of f is bounded for every f, right? So therefore by uniform boundedness theorem we can say that the sequence norm of gn is also bounded, right? And norm of gn is nothing but norm of xn, right? Because yahan se agar norm of gn nikalenge hum, that would be norm of gn of f, that would be norm of f of xn, and norm of f of xn is nothing but, this is would be nothing but norm of xn, right? So therefore sequence norm of xn is bounded. Ab isme main important point kya hai ki humne jo uniform boundedness theorem lagayi hai, ye humne lagayi hai functionals ke upar, राइट? जबकि हमने प्रूफ की थी ऑपरेटर्स पे, राइट? सो फॉर उसके लिए अल्टरनेटिव थ्योरम जो है, अल्टरनेटिव स्टेटमेंट है वो यूज होगी, बिकॉज हमें क्या गिवन है, एक्स एक बनाक स्पेस, वाई एक नॉर्म स्पेस ओवर द फील्ड. वी आर गिवन अ सेट ऑफ बाउंडेड लीनियर ऑपरेटर्स फ्रॉम एक्स टू वाई इज पॉइंट वाइज बाउंडेड, देन इट विल बी यूनिफॉर्मली कन्वर्जेंट, राइट? सो अगर ये पॉइंट वाइज बाउंडेड लीनियर ऑपरेटर्स के लिए होल्ड कर रहा है, दैट मीन्स हर एक ऑपरेटर के लिए डिफाइन कर रहा है, एंड फंक्शनल इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ ऑपरेटर जिसका जो वाई स्पेस है दैट इज ऑल द फील्ड, राइट? सो देयरफॉर ये फंक्शंस के लिए भी होल्ड करेगी स्टेटमेंट, राइट? सो देयरफॉर वी हैव द स्टेटमेंट इफ एक्स एन इज द बनाक स्पेस में है एंड एफ ऑफ एक्स एन बाउंडेड है, देन नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स एन वुड बी बाउंडेड सीक्वेंस. क्लियर है ये या कोई डाउट? सेक्शन. नाउ फॉर दिस सेक्शन व्हाट वी हैव दिस, सी द क्वेश्चंस. Find the rare sets in discrete metric space. We have done this question. Find a meager dense set in R2. This is easy to done, right? We have already done it. Category set of integers, rational numbers, right? We have already done question number 5 also, that the subset M of a metric space is rare if and only if this M closure complement in dense in X. Question 6 has also been done. 7 to nahi hai. Now, next, what we have to do is show that the completeness of X is essential in the theorem 4.7.3. 4.7.3 जो है, theorem कौन सी थी? This Bayes category theorem, जिसमें X जो है completeness जरूरी है and cannot be omitted. So उसके लिए L infinity space जो है उसमें consider करेंगे. Therefore, the sequences जो कि eventually zero हो रही हैं, right? For J greater than equals to J, जो eventually zero sequences जो है. Then Tn को अगर हम Fn Xn से define कर देंगे, example हमने किया है n of zeta n, right? So therefore point wise bounded हो रहा है, but ये uniformly bounded नहीं था, right? So we have already done this question. Okay, 11th question is also done. 12th question you can do yourself, it is easy. Okay, so with this section is complete. Section 4.8 we'll do in the next class. There was a single note that I have to do. I have to tell, and that was in the tute question, I guess. Yeah, this question. Question number 9, we were given that T is from H to H, Hilbert space to Hilbert space is an operator which is isometric and non-unitary. Then we had to prove that TH is strictly contained in H, that means not equals to and closed, right? So I had omitted the closed part. I have already shown that T is not surjective, therefore TH of H it would not be equals to H, but I have not proved that this is closed, right? So closed ko proof karna padega, that means there would closed proof karne ke liye what we take is iske closure mein ek sequence lenge, right? Closure mein ek element lenge X belongings to TH closure, right? And then we'll say ki sequence exists karti hai which converges to X, राइट? सो नाउ सीक्वेंस जो है कन्वर्ज कर रही है, दैट मींस ये कॉशी हो जाएगी, हिल्बर्ट स्पेस में है, कंप्लीट स्पेस है, राइट? सो देयरफॉर कॉशी सीक्वेंस है, नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स एन माइनस एक्स एम निकाल सकते हैं, राइट? नाउ ये टी ऑफ एच क्लोजर में ले रहे हैं, सो इसको हम नाम देते हैं टी ऑफ एक्स, राइट? फॉर एक्स बिलोंगिंग्स टू एच, टी ऑफ एक्स जो है वो टी ऑफ एच में बिलोंग करेगा, तो राइट, टेक दैट एलिमेंट टी ऑफ एक्स जो है वो टी एच इसके क्लोजर में बिलोंग कर रहा है, दैट मींस टी ऑफ एक्स एन जो है वो टी ऑफ एक्स को कन्वर्ज कर रहा है, राइट? सो दैट मींस नॉर्म ऑफ टी एक्स एन माइनस टी एक्स एम हम निकाल सकते हैं, राइट? सो देयरफॉर दैट वुड बी इक्वल्स टू, नाउ सिंस टी जो है हमें आइसोमेट्रिक दिया हुआ है, दैट वुड बी इक्वल्स टू नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स एन माइनस एम, राइट? एंड एक्स एन क्या था, सीक्वेंस इन एच हिल्बर्ट स्पेस, दैट मींस ये कॉची हो जाएगी, देयरफॉर दिस वुड टेंड्स टू जीरो, राइट? सो देयरफॉर क्लोजनेस प्रॉपर्टी होल्ड कर जाएगी, राइट? सो इसको क्लोज प्रूव करना रहता था, विच इज डन. Now any doubt you can ask.